Huey, Dewey, and Louie. Huey, Dewey, and Louie Duck are triplet cartoon characters created in 1937 by writer Ted Osborne and cartoonist Al Taliaferro, and are owned by the Walt Disney Company. Huey, Dewey, and Louie are the nephews of Donald Duck and the grandnephews of Scrooge McDuck. Like their uncles, the boys are anthropomorphic white ducks with yellow-orange bills and feet. They typically wear shirts and colorful baseball caps, which are sometimes used to differentiate each character. Huey, Dewey and Louie have made several animated appearances in both films and television, but comics remain their primary medium. The trio are collectively the 11th most published comic book characters in the world, and outside of the superhero genre, second only to Donald. While the boys were originally created as mischief makers to provoke Donald's famous temper, later appearances showed them to be valuable assets to him and Scrooge on their adventures. All three of the boys are members of the fictional scouting organization the Junior Woodchucks. Huey, Dewey, and Louie were the idea of Al Taliaferro, the artist for the Silly Symphonies comic strip, which featured Donald Duck. The Walt Disney Productions Story Department on February 5, 1937, sent Taliaferro a memo recognizing him as the source of the idea for the planned short, Donald's Nephews. The nephews debuted in Taliaferro's comic strip, which by this time had been renamed Donald Duck, on Sunday, October 17, 1937, beating the theatrical release of Donald's Nephews by almost 6 months. According to Don Rosa, Carl Barks has claimed that in fact they were his creation while working as a writer on Donald Duck animated cartoons in 1937. The names were devised by Disney gagman Dana Cody, who took them from Huey Long, Thomas Dewey, and Louie Schmidt, an animator at the Disney studio in the 1930s and 1940s. Taliaferro's introduction of the nephews emulated the three nephews in the Happy Hooligan comic strip and was also influenced by Mickey Mouse's nephews, Morty and Ferdy Field Mouse. In translations of Disney works, the nephews have different local-sounding names that often follow the repetition, paracasis, of the English names. Examples include Hugo, Paco and Luis, American Spanish, Jorgito, Juanito and Jaimito, European Spanish, and Tick, Trick and Track, German, and Nicky, Tiki and Vicky, Hungary. Huey, Dewey, and Louie are the sons of Donald's sister Della Duck. In Donald's Nephews, their mother is instead named Dumbella. In the original theatrical shorts, they were originally sent to visit Donald for only one day. In the comics, the three were sent to stay with Donald on a temporary basis, until their father came back from the hospital. The boys ended up sending him there after a practical joke of putting firecrackers under his chair. In both the comics and animated shorts, the boys' parents were never heard from or mentioned again after these instances, with the boys ending up permanently living with Donald. All four of them live in the fictional city of Duckburg, in the fictional state of Calisoda. The three ducklings are noted for their identical appearances and personalities. A running joke involves the three sometimes even finishing each other's sentences. In the theatrical shorts, Huey, Dewey, and Louie often behave in a rambunctious and mischievous manner, and they sometimes commit retaliation or revenge in their Uncle Donald Duck. In the comics, however, as developed by Al Taliaferro and Carl Barks, the young ducks are more usually portrayed as well-behaved, preferring to assist their Uncle Donald Duck and Great-Uncle Scrooge McDuck in the adventure at hand. In the early Barks comics, the ducklings were still wild and unruly, but their character improved considerably due to their membership in the Junior Woodchucks and the good influence of their wise old great-grandmother Elvira Coot Grandma Duck. According to Don Rosa, Huey, Dewey and Louie became members of the Junior Woodchucks when they were around 11 years old. In early comic books and shorts, the caps of Huey, Dewey, and Louie were colored randomly, depending on the whim of the colorist. On few occasions until 1945 and most every cartoon short afterward, all three nephews wore identical outfits, most commonly red. It wasn't until the 1980s when it became established that Huey is dressed in red, Dewey in blue, and Louie in green. Disney's archivist Dave Smith, in Disney A to Z, said, "Note that the brightest hue of the three is red, Huey, the color of water, Dew, is blue, Dewey, and that leaves Louie, and leaves are green." A few random combinations appear in early Disney merchandise and books, such as orange and yellow. Another combination that shows up from time to time is Huey in blue, Dewey in green, and Louie in red. In story, this inconsistency is explained away as a result of the ducklings borrowing each other's clothes. In Donald Duck and Uncle Scrooge comics, the trio have occasionally been known to dress in their usual outfits, but rather than have their usual colors, they all wear black, or the same dark color, rendering them visually identical, leaving their hat color available if they care to be distinguished. One story in Donald Duck comics was based around Donald spending so much time trying to tell his three nephews apart that he developed a heightened sense of sight. Clarence Nash, Donald's voice actor, gave the voices to the boys in the cartoon shorts, making them just as unintelligible as Donald S. Huey, Dewey, and Louie were all voiced by Russi Taylor in DuckTales. In Quack Pack, they were voiced by Jeannie Elias, Pamela Siegel, and Elizabeth Daly, respectively. Tony and Selma voiced the characters in Down and Out with Donald Duck, 1987, Mickey Mouse works in Disney's House of Mouse, but Russi Taylor still voices the trio in other projects, such as the video games and Mickey's Speedway USA, and the direct-to-video films Mickey's Once and Twice Upon a Christmas. Russi Taylor also reprised her role as the nephews in the video game and the post-2013 Mickey Mouse shorts. Danny Pudi, Ben Schwartz and Bobby Moynihan voiced the brothers in the 2017 reboot. On a few occasions, an artist by error drew four nephews and the error was not noticed but was published. This fourth nephew has been named Fooey Duck by Disney comic editor Bob Foster. One short Egmont-licensed Disney comic, called Much Ado About Fooey in the English language version, used Fooey as a character and explained Fooey's sporadic appearances as a freak incident of nature. The Swedish text in the two speech balloons says it is a fourth nephew. An exact copy of the others. /Yes, it's probably best that I explain. After the era of theatrical shorts ended, they appeared in the 1988 film Who Framed Roger Rabbit, Huey, Dewey, and Louie appear in a picture on a newspaper in Eddie Valiant's office. In 1990, the boys also made an appearance in the anti-drug TV special cartoon All Stars to the Rescue. Furthermore, they also appeared in DuckTales the movie where they go on a treasure hunt with their Uncle Scrooge and end befriending a kind-hearted genie. As the movie progresses, they make unimaginable wishes and end up having to help Uncle Scrooge face an old enemy. They also make a cameo in Mickey's Christmas Carol. They also appeared with Uncle Scrooge but without Donald in Scrooge McDuck and Money. Within the comics, Huey, Dewey, and Louie often play a major role in most stories involving either their Uncle Donald or Great Uncle Scrooge McDuck, accompanying them on most of their adventures. Also seen in the comics is the boys' membership in the Boy Scouts of America-like organization, the Junior Woodchucks, including their use of the Junior Woodchucks Guidebook, a manual containing all manner of information on virtually every subject possible. However, there are some resources, such as the ancient libraries of Tralala, that hold information not found in the guidebook. This excellent youth organization, which has twin goals of preserving knowledge and preserving the environment, was instrumental in transforming the three brothers from little hellions to upstanding young ducks. In Disney comic writer Don Rosa's unofficial continuity, Huey, Dewey, and Louie Duck were born around 1940 in Duckburg. True to his jocular style, Rosa occasionally makes subtle references to the untold mystery of the three boys' life, what became of their parents. In his epic comic series, Life and Times of Scrooge McDuck, Rosa pictures how Scrooge first met Donald and his nephews, saying, "I'm not used to relatives, either. The few I had seemed to have disappeared." Huey, Dewey, and Louie answer, "We know how that feels, Uncle Scrooge." In Some Air Over the Rainbow by Carl Barks, Huey, Dewey, and Louie, along with Donald Duck and Gladstone Gander, are tested by Scrooge McDuck, who wants to pick an heir to his fortune. Using the legend of a pot of gold at the end of a rainbow, Scrooge secretly gives $3,000, $1,000 to Huey, Dewey, and Louie, another for Gladstone, and the last one for Donald. Donald uses his money for a down payment of a new car, now being $1,000 in debt. Gladstone, considering himself too lucky to need the money this soon, hides the money for when and if he needs it, causing Scrooge to consider him a better option than Donald. Huey, Dewey, and Louie lend their money to a man who claims to need the money to search for a treasure. Initially thinking they were tricked out of the money, Scrooge actually considers leaving his fortune to Gladstone, even though he sees that as an awful injustice to the world, but the man actually finds the treasure and pays the kids back. Scrooge makes Huey, Dewey, and Louie his heirs. Although this is disregarded in a number of later comics, it seems to be the most solidly canon indication of Scrooge's plans. They later starred in the 1987 animated television series DuckTales, in which they appeared in adventures with their great-uncle, Scrooge McDuck, Donald having enlisted in the U.S. Navy. The boys' personalities in this series were mainly based on their comic book appearances versus the theatrical shorts. A new adaptation of the series once again titled, DuckTales features the three brothers as well, albeit with distinct designs, voices, and personalities like Aang Quackpack, who moved to Scrooge's house with Donald after the boat where they lived is destroyed by accident. In the new installment, the brothers also travel in adventures with Scrooge, now with Donald in tow. The first episode also shows an image of Della, the triplet's mother, who also traveled the world in adventures with Donald and Scrooge. This iteration also changed Dewey's real name to Duford, while making Deuteronomy his middle name, and Louis's real name to Llewellyn, a fact which he seems to be embarrassed by. Huey, Dewey, and Louis also starred in the 1990s series Quackpack, in which the three were portrayed as teenagers. In Quackpack, the boys were given distinct personalities, with Huey serving as the group's leader, Dewey as a computer whiz, and Louis as enjoying sports. After Quackpack, the boys were reverted to their original ages and future appearances, including 2000 series Mickey Mouse Works, and then re-aged in House of Mouse. On House of Mouse, they served as the house band in a variety of different styles, most commonly as the Quack Street Boys. They also feature prominently, in a segment of the computer-animated film, Mickey's Twice Upon a Christmas from 2004. Huey, Dewey, and Louie appear in the third Magical Quest game. The object of the game is to rescue them from the clutches of a villainous King Pete. The trio also appear in Quackshot piloting Donald's plane as he travels the world in search of a lost treasure. They also appear in the Lucky Dime Caper for the Sega Master System, where they are kidnapped by Magic It Is Spell. Donald must find Scrooge's Lucky Dime and barter for their safety. They also appear in, aiding Donald to rescue Daisy and beat Gladstone to her, while he rescues their Hex Play Toys. They even appear in Mickey's Speedway USA as unlockable lightweight characters. They also appear in DuckTales, aiding their Uncle Scrooge in finding treasure. They also appear on, where they appear as DJs on certain music tracks. In Kingdom Hearts they work in the item shop in the first district of Traverse Town. In Kingdom Hearts 2, they individually run an item shop, Huey, a weapon shop, Louie, and an accessory shop, Dewey, in Hollow Bastion / Radiant Garden. In both endings, they are all seen going back to Disney Castle. They reappear in Disney Town, recreating ice cream flavors, this time with a speaking role. They appear once more in the mobile game Kingdom Hearts Unchained as special support medals that grant the players other medals a set amount of experience points based on the medal's star value. Huey, Dewey and Louie appear as characters only at Tokyo Disney and Disneyland Paris. Huey, Dewey and Louie only appeared in seasonal parades Easter, Halloween and Christmas 2011 after a long absence. They also appeared in the Countdown Party Parade 2011. Huey, Dewey and Louie appear more regularly in Paris. They appeared during the Christmas season 2010 in their daytime and nighttime parades at the Disneyland Park Disneyland Paris's Magic Kingdom Disney's Once Upon a Dream Parade and in the Disney's Fantillusion Parade in glittery outfits. They made another appearance at Disneyland Paris for meet and greet at the Disneyland Hotel on April 2, 2011, the day of the press event for the launch of their new season Magical Moments Festival. They also appeared at the Disney's Once Upon a Dream Parade at the Disneyland Park in special outfits for the parody and at the Disney's Stars and Cars Parade at the Walt Disney Studios Park in a unique director's outfits. The three nephews appeared at Disneyland Paris's Halloween season 2011. They have their own show during Mickey's Not-So-Scary Halloween Parties at Disneyland Park in Disneyland Paris, titled Huey, Dewey and Louie's Trick or Treat Party. They also made an appearance for meet and greet at Disneyland Paris's Disney's Halloween Party on October 31, 2011. This is the first time ever that the three nephews appear for meet and greet at any of the Disney parks for regular park guests. They were also part of the Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve 2011-2012 celebrations at the Disneyland Hotel. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.